For the noble defenders of Demacia, daily life is the very model of focused, selfless dedication to the ideals of king and country. Called upon to continue his family's long tradition of military service, Tariq never dreamed of shirking that responsibility, though he would not limit or define exactly whom and what he would protect. The young warrior trained hard and possessed great martial skill. Even so, in his scant hours of free time, he would find other ways to serve his homeland. He volunteered for the Illuminators, tending the sick or helping rebuild homes damaged by flooding. He lent his creative talents, such as they were, to the stonemasons and craftsmen who raised monuments to the glory of the Winged Protector and the lofty ideals it embodied. A work of art, a stranger's life, these were the things that made Demacia worth fighting for. Tariq saw every one of them as beautiful, fragile, and worthy of saving. Fortunately, his disarming manner and innate warmth allowed him to brush aside any criticism from his fellow soldiers or commanding officers. He rose modestly through the ranks, and even fought beside a young Garen Crown Guard. Ironically, it was Tariq's steady rise that would bring about his eventual downfall, at least as far as Demacia was concerned. Elevated to the prestigious Dauntless Vanguard, he was suddenly held to a far higher standard of conduct. No more would he be allowed to roam the forest looking for glimpses of some rare animal, neglect combat drills to sit in a tavern and listen to a bard's simple ballad, or skip line inspections to ride out and observe the silver cloak of night settling across the hinterlands. Tariq began to feel at odds with himself, and soon attracted attention as an insubordinate. Garen urged him to shape up and do his duty. He could see Tariq had the potential to become one of Valoran's greatest heroes, and yet he seemed to be thumbing his nose at destiny as well as his country. To keep him from demotion, Tariq was seconded to serve the Sword Captain of the Vanguard, though neither of them was particularly happy about it. However, when the older man was slain in battle along with the rest of his personal retinue, Tariq was found to have abandoned his post. And rumor had it he had been spotted wandering the cloisters of some forgotten ruined temple nearby. Nothing more could be said. A dozen warriors were dead and Tariq faced executioner's block for it. However, seeking mercy for his friend, Garen intervened. As the Sword Captain's successor, he sentenced Tariq to endure the Crown of Stone. In accordance with Demacia's most ancient traditions, he would be sent to climb Mount Targon, a trial that few had ever survived. Though the Crown of Stone usually allowed the designer to simply flee Demacia and start a new life in exile, Tariq took the first ship heading south and swore to actually atone for what he had done. The climb nearly claimed him, body and soul, numerous times, but Tariq pushed past the pain, the ghosts of his dead comrades, and other tests inflicted upon him by the mountain. As he approached the summit, he was beset by a wave of new visions of loss and destruction. He witnessed the great alabaster library set aflame, and still he dashed into the inferno to retrieve the heavenly poetries of Tang. He screamed in anguish as the Frost Guard ran the last dream stag into the howling abyss, and then leapt over the precipice himself in a desperate attempt to save it. At the gates of the immortal bastion, Tariq slumped to his knees when he saw Garen's broken body swinging from a gibbet, before raising his shield and charging headlong into the waiting hordes of Noxus. When the visions finally faded, Tariq found himself at the very pinnacle of the mountain, and he was not alone. Before him stood something wearing the shape of a man, though its most crystalline features blazed with the light of the stars themselves, and his voice was a thousand whispers that cut through Tariq like a blade. It spoke truths he had somehow always known. It spoke of the mantle for which he had unwittingly been preparing his entire life, with every decision and deed that he had brought him here, now to Targon, and he would stand as the shield of Valoran in great wars yet to come. Reborn as the aspect of the Protector, gifted with power and purpose unimaginable to most mortals, Tariq has gladly accepted his new calling as the steadfast guardian of an entire world.